Hello and welcome to the new video. So this time I tried myself into building the new Penance brand because he has a very good numbers in the POB, so I'm like, hell, I'll give it a try. And I did some Uber bosses and some mapping and so on. You're gonna see that in the timestamps, so just click whatever you want to see. So generally speaking, creating this build took me about, I would say, 10 defines of maybe a little bit more. Overall, for this kind of value of the device, this is a great build. But nothing is perfect, and the build has like pros and cons. I would say the main things that I don't like about the build is like using a shield charge. I'm not a big fan of the shield charge, but that's one of the things that you have to use to have like a decent flow of a movement while mapping and so on. Another thing that not necessarily like to, it's just a decent mapper. It's not like a great mapper, it's a decent, because the skill has like a ramp up time. It needs some ticks to get to that big juicy damage that you see in the POB. So that's like a two main things that I'm not necessarily like about the main. Maybe a setting point, if you want to call it like that, with this build is it's a great boss because it's a brand playset, because you're gonna just place a brand on a boss and then you can move around, focus on dodging rather than trying to do the damage and dodging the mechanics of the boss. You can just place a brand, move around, and the boss gonna be dying. Not only that, even if you're dead and you're laying on the floor, as long as you have a brand, place it on the enemy or on the boss, whatever, the brand will still do the damage. So sometimes what might happen is that you're gonna die on a boss and you're just gonna leave the brand, and the brand might actually kill the boss. So that's like a nifty trick that you can use with the brand playstyle. Of course, this is not a hardcore viable strategy. When you're gonna be viewing the passive tree, especially I did not take the rune binder, as I'm gonna link you in the description, there's a topic to the official POE forum that you can only attach one brand, and that brand will get to the 20 stages when there's like the biggest damage. If you take the rune binder and you attach two of them, they're gonna be doing less damage. I don't know if that's how the brand's supposed to be working, or does the GG just gonna fix it and we're gonna be able to attach two brands. But if the future, or maybe GG released a patch notes or whatever, you can attach two brands and they can still get to the 20 stages, you should absolutely get that keystone right away, because that's pretty much gonna double your damage. Overall, if you're gonna be starting an Inquisitor, I would say go for it, because I personally did not level up the character starting from the scratch with the brands, but one of my guildmates started that, and he was just using a Penance brand and faced lightning, and he had like an absolute blast. So definitely a viable starting gem if you would start the new Templar just to have fun with the build. So now I'm just gonna leave you a couple clips of me at doing my challenge for the Uber bosses, and in the process dying quite a bit. So this is a non-Uber version because I forgot to put the passive on. But this video, this clip is gonna demonstrate to you the defense of the build, because I'm gonna be tanking quite a lot of the beam.
Disintegration, cleansing, annihilation. No. This realm shall be studied by Violet of Thousand Studies. disintegration. Calamity. Surprises.
What a mysterious crisp. Mortal flesh is so fallible. Grasp your mortality tightly. Resist the assault. I want more like this one.
Horu Antariak! Marked for death. A sliver of what my home feels like. Wildwood's power is mine! Running. The dominion is mine. This is not the end.
For the bandit choice, we're choosing to kill all of the bandits and gaining 2 points. For the Pantheon choice, mainly we're gonna be using the Soul of Brian King for the stone, as there's no other way just to mitigate the stone on this build. So the Brian King is absolutely mandatory because of this situation. And the Minor Gods can be choose and pick whatever you want to the different situation. But I'm using Soul of Aberrant simply because I'm running Red Altars and the Burning Grounds might be just degening me a little bit. So your ascendancy points should go Normal, Cruel, Merciless, Eternal. For your secondary class ascendancy, whatever that's probably called, I'm using Primalist, simply for the three charms, as those charms are very powerful. The first one is a flexible charm, so you could take it out and put whatever you want. But I wanted to have, you cannot take reflective damage, as this is a huge quality of life while mapping, and I have some like crit multi per power charge. The crit multi per power charge is a very like desirable charm for you. I think it goes up to 5%, and since you are stacking power charges, this gives you a lot of multi for free. It's pretty much. So this is you're gonna see that I'm pretty much stacking this on every single charm. The next one is the same thing, multi per power charge. This just simply gives you the damage, and this is a very important thing. There's a 22% chance to create consecrated ground when you hit a rare or unique enemy. And this is very important, as if you look on your ascendancy class over here, if you create a consecrated ground, it increases the damage while the enemies are standing on the consecrated ground. So this note, the 22% chance helps you out triggering this ascendancy node when we get increased damage on the enemies. That's like a nifty trick. And the last one, I went with the power charge, and I went with something that would actually benefit the build. That would be the hinder. So here's your flask choice that you're gonna be using. First one, you're gonna be using a Hallowed Life flask, and you wanna roll yourself instantly recovery on low life. This pretty much is gonna be your panic flask whenever you get like a hit, some kind of chaos damage, and you see you're on, you know, very low, you just hit it and you're back to the full life. And the suffix is pretty much doesn't matter. You can have the corrupted blood and bleeding immunity, but you know, that's not important as I'm solving those two problems in the build. So you can have it, but it's not necessarily needed. The same second flask is a diamond, where you're gonna be trying to get yourself a chance to gain flask charges whenever you crit. Then you craft on yourself used charges when they reach full from the bench. And then you can, if you have reduced mana cost of skills. The reduced mana cost of skills is not necessarily needed. It's like a good quality of life because you have enough mana region to just simply hold your brand, and you're never gonna run out of the mana. So that's something to have in mind, that you can actually replace them reduced mana cost if you don't have it. And the three other flasks, you're gonna be using Topaz, Granite, and Sapphire. And you're looking for your suffixes. You're looking for the cures, increased armor, and cast speed. And ideally, you want to have gain 3 charges when you're hit by the enemy on those flasks, and then you would have some kind of cast speed, increased armor, and reduced cures. And pretty much you would have like a perma uptime on the flask because you're getting hit quite a lot. The passive tree is very straight and forward. there's not much happening. I don't even need to explain too much. The only thing that you need to know, if you didn't listen at the beginning of the video, currently there is either a bug or that's how intended the Penance brand works. Let me just say this again. Currently, you should not be using the rune binder, because if you attach two Penance brand to one enemy, they will never hit that maximum amount of energy, and you won't see that big explosion, and you won't be doing the maximum damage of the brand. If GGG fix that, or they're gonna say, okay, that's how the brand works, then you should never have this point. But on the other hand, if GGG say like, okay, we made a mistake or whatever the case, now the Penance brand works fine with the rune binder, you should automatically right away unspec some kind of node, even that of one of node over here, maybe the Lightning Mastery, whatever you need to do, you need to rush right away. But only if GGG tells in the patch note or some kind of Reddit post or whatever that the Penance brand works fine with the rune binder, because what that's gonna do, the rune binder with the fix doubles your damage. But for now, this is a waste of a point. So let's start the build with the first item, and this item is a core piece. You need to, if you don't have it, don't even try to recreate the build. It's the Ralakesh boots. Do you want to call them either in this league? Do they got a nerf or a buff? Whatever camp you are, for me, they got a buff. Because you always count as having the maximum endurance, frenzy, and power charges, no matter what. In the past, you will only gain them while you were stationary. So for the most of the builds, those boots provide huge amount of power, and this build takes advantage of this. So you might be wondering why I don't see the power charges like in the past over here, or frenzy charges or endurance charges. Let me just warn that they do still work, because if you look on my crit chance, it's 74.1. if I remove my boots, it goes really, really low. That's how you know it works properly. And the gems that you're gonna be using in your boots is gonna be Arrogance, Link with Defiance Banner, Vitality, Clarity. So moving on to another core piece item that you need to have is Badge of the Brotherhood. And you can buy the cheapest one as you can, because we don't really actually care about stats on this item. The only stats that we care and is that your maximum frenzy charges are equal to your power charges. And if you look on over here, my power charges are 11, and that makes my frenzy charges 11 as well. This is the main use for this amulet. And what else you can do is apply 20 attribute catalysts. This is gonna give you 4 extra dexterity, 4 extra intelligence, and you can apply Discipline of Slaughter. This is gonna give you increased damage per frenzy charges. Since you have 11 frenzy charges, this gives you a hell of a lot of damage. So before I describe the shield, this is a core piece of the build, and you need to buy it right away as quickly as possible. The Malachi Loop will give you +2 maximum power charges and some increased spell damage per power charge and other goodies. If you can get yourself a corrupted one when you take reduced damage from the critical strike, that would be great. But if the implicit is too expensive for now, you can skip it, as the basic shield is far more important than the implicit. But implicit is very important as well. And the gems that you're gonna be keeping in your shield is gonna be Steel Skin, Shield Charge, Faster Attack. And you can level up the Faster Attack as high as your dexterity allows you to do. So the helmet is actually one of the flexible slots that you can do. But I was looking to get myself an implicit on some kind of decent unique helmet, +1 maximum power charges. And I went with this one when I gained 30% extra energy shield from my maximum mana. And that costed me about 10c. But ideally, what kind of helmet you would like to have is the one that you see on the left. But currently it's very expensive, because it goes between 9 to 10 or a bit more divines. And the gems that you're going to be keeping in your helmet is going to be Enlightened level 3. That's very important. You're gonna be using Petrifying Blood, Determination, Purity of Elements. The chest I'm using is Cloak of Flame. Simply for the converted 40% physical damage taken to fire, it gives me some extra resistance, and this is very important. You take reduce critical damage. If you cannot afford a Cloak of Flame with the implicit, for now you can ignore it. But let me just say like this: if you're gonna be doing the T16 maps and you're gonna be juicing your maps with the Blue Wisp, the Blue Wisp adds a lot of critical damage to the monsters. So I would say this is a very important implicit, but you know, you can play Witch out the implicit, but if you can get yourself the currency, buy this chest with this implicit right away. This will increase your survivability in this league very, very much. And I'm using my new Penance brand. Then I'm using increased critical damage, Fist Lightning, Power Charge on Critical Strike, Awaken added lightning damage. You can temporarily use the normal one. The Awaken one is super cheap, so why not? And I'm using Inspiration. So your gloves gonna be something that you're gonna be feeling missing stats resistance that you need. In my case, I needed some lightning resistance. You remember, when you're looking for a trait, it doesn't have to be a lightning resistance. It can be a different, and you can just swap your resistance on harvest bench. So have that in mind when you're browsing for the gloves. So I needed some resistance, I needed the dexterity because I wanted to take my faster attack to much higher levels. I wanted some chaos resistance and life. And the most important thing, I wanted to have just a standard stock pair of gloves with no influence, because I wanted to use the Aether and Exarch orbs to get myself the 0.2 lightning damage leeches life, since I'm a Petrifying Blood. As long as I'm not on full life, I will have a constant leech because of that. And then I'll get myself a unnerf. This is give me a little bit of a damage. And the gems that you're going to be using in your gloves is Mid Shield, Rise Spectre, Wrath, Guardian Blessing. I'm using the new tech added in this league, when you can buy yourself from a trade a corpses that call a Dark Marionette. Once you buy yourself the corpses, they're gonna be your inventory. You do right click in your hideout, the corpse is gonna go on the floor, and then you click on your Rise Spectre and you rise the two specters. That's gonna be those little guys over here. And then you're gonna see on your bar that you can use Wrath, or you can even turn it off if you want. But when you turn it on, is degening the Rise Spectre, the marionette. But since we are an Inquisitor and we have a vitality, we have a consolidated ground and so on, those specters stay alive for a very, very long time. But occasionally, whenever they die, they will resurrect themselves back to the life. But you have to take a look on the Wrath, because sometimes the Wrath might be turned off because your two specters, they die. So you're just gonna have to, you know, press the Wrath back and the aura on, and the Wrath's gonna be working again. Well, I would recommend keep the Guardian Blessing at level 1, then the Spectre will pretty much never die, because you know, you're an Inquisitor, you have a vitality, you have the consecrated ground, so they are getting a lot of regen because of that. You could level up this to level 20, get a little bit more damage, but what's gonna happen? The Spectre is gonna be dying a little bit more often. And for me, you know, sure, you can get extra 1 million out damage into that, but it just gets a little bit annoying to keeping an eye on your Wrath, when I can simply press it once and pretty much they don't die, unless there's some kind of big explosion and they're gonna, you know, walk into that. So moving on to the belt is absolutely mandatory. It's a super cheap item. If you can get yourself the corruption for the increased skill effect duration, the 14% I think is the bare minimum that you should be buying. Anything below is you shouldn't be buying that, just buy a clean version or like the cheapest one. So why this belt is so important? First of all, it gives us +1 maximum power charges, it gives us some increased energy shield, then it gives us a lightning resistance. And this is very important. you gain absorption charges whenever instead of the power charges. And actually, this would be very bad, even if the charges, the special charges from this belt are great, because you recoup elemental damage as an energy shield, and that actually makes you very, very tanky. But there's a solution for this belt. If you look on the Ralakesh simply states that you have the charges, and that's it. No matter what, you have the charges. So, if you socket yourself in your brand the power charge on critical strike, you're gonna be gaining those special charges instead of the power charges, but you will still keep your power charges because the Ralakesh say you have them no matter what. That's why the combination of these boots with this belt and this gem makes absolutely insane amount of defense for this build. So moving up to the rings, you're gonna be using Call of the Brotherhood. This is a very defensive ring, as it provides you with whenever you kill an enemy, they're gonna be shattering, so there's gonna be no like corpse explosions and so on. And whatever chill you see on the enemy, half of that you're gonna get a damage reduction. So this ring is a very defensive item. I love it, you should buy it, no matter what. It's not too expensive. The second one, my favorite, since we are on a low life, we're gonna be getting ourselves a Lori Lantern. Again, great ring, getting resistance, chaos resistance. You can get yourself implicit for the bleeding, cannot be inflicted on you. And we're getting the unlucky damage when the enemies are hitting us. Again, another great defensive item. For your main weapon, you're gonna be using Void Battery. This pretty much is a mandatory wand, as it has everything that we actually need. And the sockets that you're gonna be keeping in your Void Battery is gonna be Frostblink, linked with the Arcane Suit level 1, keep it at level 1, and then you're gonna be using Brand Recall. Because if you keep the Arcane Suit on level 1, whenever you use a Frostblink or Brand Recall, you're gonna be maintaining the Arcane Suit. And main things that we're taking from the Arcane Suit is the cast speed. The rest of them is not relevant for us. There are three map modifiers that you should stay away. The first one is Elemental Reflect. If you don't have the charm like me, Elemental Reflect is a no-go for you. If you have the charm, this is a one less modifier for you to deal. Another one is less recovery rate of life energy shield, or there's something like no recovery life or like end energy shield. Those two modifiers are pretty much bad for the build, as you're pretty much basing the whole character defense on the recovery. So if you take that away from the character, it's pretty much a dead character. So if you're wondering what's going to happen with the build will stay as it is. There's going to be no videos, no POV updates, pretty much. But that's what you see in the POV, that's what you're getting. My main goal with this build is to get myself the challenge for the pinnacle bosses. And I did achieve that, as you can see in the video. There's a couple clips of me doing the Uber version of the bosses. So that will be it for the character. I would really appreciate if you can hit the like button and subscribe button, as this really helps me out growing the channel. Thank you for watching. I will see you later in my next video.